This game is tea and is not suitable for kids. We probably arrive at the classroom the moment the bell rings.
Ah, Okazaki.
Yeah? Huh? I passed her in the hallway, and then things turned out like this.
それだけ?
Yep, that's all.
それは奇跡的な出来事だったね。一生に一度あるかないかぐらいのね。
Sunohara walks to his seat on unsteady feet. It was a somewhat pitiful sight. It's not morning, it's the afternoon.
6時間目って何だっけ?
Can't you tell by looking? How do people pass classes if they don't go to class? Oh, that's right, they don't.
Huh?
There are no girls to be seen in class any longer. It's turned into a boys' locker room. There's definitely Game Boy Girl there, and there are the girls behind Sunohara as well.
Taika? Ido daru?
Yo, nani arutte?
Soccer datte yo.
Oh, he's gonna get excited about this.
Daru?
Oh, interesting, Mirko. Okay, that could be interesting. I might check it out in the future. I have a lot of other I have a huge list of other things that I want to play first, though. And it just keeps getting longer. It's your one chance to show off as a former member of the soccer team, after all.
Heh. 格の違いってもう見せてやるさ!
PE isn't so much a class as much as it's a study break. We're just supposed to play a little match as a breather. You can ignore the ball and chat with friends outright, and the teacher still won't say anything. Third year PE classes are pretty meaningless like that. They're just filler at this stage. The only energetic voice to be heard is the one belonging to the idiot who's given up on going to college. Well, that's rich coming from you, Tomoya. I mean, you were playing against people who were talking to their friends, so probably not, Sunohara. Yeah, you're a prodigy. You're more than J-Leaguer, you're J-Beefer. I thought it sounded more delicious than cool. I heard you wheezing up a storm during the second half. I'm telling you, I'm broke. Oh yeah, now we get to skip. Still, it's worthwhile on some level. Doing this has at least helped kill time that would have otherwise been dull. I think this is about going to the arcade. The Illusionary World 4. We've already done this. No, we haven't done this, apparently. Okay. There was no decision there, no. She made this body of mine. It's made out of junk. I thought we've already done this! Did we only do three of them? The pieces of junk dot this vast plain, scattered among the dry grass. They're buried in the ground, and their corners jut out from the earth. They look like corpses of some sort to me. Okay, no, this is a new one. Tons of dead bodies. All kinds of dead bodies. As I think about it, I shudder. My body is made of those pieces. Yet this junk was able to come together to make a proper body. It's not as if I find my limbs suddenly falling off for no reason. In that case, it should be impossible to make another conscious junk doll, just like how I was made. If you search around here, you can find all the scrap you'd ever need. I can see. It's a cornfield, though, on my screen. I use my small body to begin gathering junk, just as I'm sure she did when putting me together. She looks at me quizzically as I do it. I try to connect the pieces of scrap together in front of her. But while I may be able to put one piece into another, they always fall apart. She understands what I'm trying to do, though, and she does it for me. This time, the pieces stay. I point to my own body. You want a new body? I cross my arms to tell her that this has nothing to do with me. A friend? You want a friend? That's not why I'm doing this. I just felt like things would be more fun if there were more dolls like me around. But either way, the result will be the same, so I nod. Yes, I guess you're right. You were lonely by yourself. I'm sorry. That's not true. But I continue to stare up at the girl's face. I might not be able to do it. Is that okay? I nod. Then I'll try. The girl begins to put the junk together. When we run out of parts, we walk around the plane to find more. We go back and forth, making trip after trip. It's only after doing this that I begin to realize something. Making my body was so much work. We've traveled far to find scrap today. We stand at the top of a hill, looking out at the horizon. The earth stretches on endlessly. It goes out as far as the eye can see. What could I be on the other side of it? I compare myself to the grass growing next to me, but I can't tell for sure with this tiny body of mine. Look. I turn around to face the voice, and I see her holding an animal to her chest. So there were living creatures in this world apart from me. It's covered in fluffy white hair and has two curly horns, one by each ear. I don't like it. It doesn't seem to have any interest in people, not that I'm a person. It's as if it doesn't even notice us. Still, she enjoys playing with it, even if it doesn't react. She pats it on its head and tummy as she holds it, all the while slowly climbing the hill. I follow after her. At the top of one hill, we find a herd of these animals. While they're all of different sizes, both big and small, they're the same species. The girl places the animal she's holding down on the ground. It walks towards its herd, not even looking back at her once. Seeing this makes me think. They must not have hearts. They just exist. If it never had any interest in her, of course it wouldn't turn back or feel sad about parting ways. Still, the only living creatures in this world besides her are those things. That must be why she enjoys interacting with them. As I watch the animals, I see them unemotionally tear flowers out of the ground they're sprouting on and chewing them up. If those things keep multiplying, this green field will quickly become a wasteland. No matter how much she loves them, she surely wouldn't want that to happen. I place the junk I'm carrying down on the ground and then charge into the pack of animals to drive them off. At least, I try to do that, but they give up without a fight, change locations, and begin to eat more grass. My actions were meaningless. What's wrong? Are you mad? I hear the girl's voice behind me. No, I'm sad. Do you want me to pat your head? Well, yes, I do. I sit still, looking at the now upturned soil. Does she not feel anything when she sees nature like this despoiled? Not sadness or loneliness? She crouches down and pats my head. I can tell by the shadows. There's just nothing we can do about this. Those are her words to me. She goes on. Ah, things are always changing. That's the only thought I can come to. Still have no clue what's going on there. April 22nd is a Tuesday. I'm late again this morning, but that's par for the course at this stage. I exhale deeply as if to prepare myself for the day ahead, and climb the empty hill alone. I take a look at my watch. Third period is nearly over, and lunch break is about to start. Until last year, I would just enter the classroom without caring what period it was. Occasionally, I would get into an argument with the teacher right then and there, and I would end up interrupting class. But if I continued doing that now that I'm a third year, it would be a bother to my classmates who are working hard studying for their exams right now. Trying to come to school during the break is more or less me being considerate in my own way. Not to mention, it's also better to stay on the teacher's good sides. There's no one who could take me to task for anything if I came to school during break. Oh, she ain't happy though. Nope, there is one.
こんな時間にカバンを持ってどこに行っていたんだ? まさか今投稿してきたとは言わないな?
I wonder what would happen if I told her I did. I'm on my way home. No. Good question. stay silent. Well, I have some stuff going on, so don't ask about why I'm late.
聞いてはいけないと言われると、ますます聞きたくなるな。
Please don't.
なら、お前のクラスの者に事情を聞くとしよう。
Huh?
1時間目からいたかどうかな。
No, wait!
なんだ、自分から言う気になったか。
Yeah, I'm late. And is that so bad? I become defiant.
悪いかと聞かれると、悪いとしか答えようがないぞ。
It's very true. Surprisingly, Tomoyo didn't scold me over this. Yeah, because it's obvious it is. Well, I'll hurry along now then. Seeing a good opportunity, I cut the conversation and try to detach as quickly as possible.
待て、理由を聞かせろ。遅刻した理由だ。
I just overslept is all. She was about to try and follow me all the way into the classroom, so I answered her in order to keep her out.
そうか。岡崎は朝が弱いんだな。
Don't just suddenly decide that for yourself.
じゃあ、別に理由があるんだな。
That doesn't matter, does it?
心配して聞いてやってるんだぞ。それともなんだ？迷惑か？
Well, I mean, I can't speak for Tomoyo. She's not bothering me. No, it's not like you're bothering me or anything. How should I put it? I'm saying, don't you have far more important things to do?
やること？
Yeah. Didn't you only just get admitted not too long ago? I mean, even yesterday, you just left your friends in the dark. Shouldn't you try to follow up with them?
ないがしろとかフォローとか言われてもピンとこないんだが。私が何か悪いことをしたか？
This morning, did you talk to those people you were with yesterday?
ああ、した。
Was it the same as always?
いつもと同じだったぞ。
They didn't say anything about me?
ああ、言っていた。
What did they say?
気軽に話していたから、親しいのかって。
And then?
いや、最近知り合ったばかりだと答えたら、みんな大笑いしていた。
Don't you think they were actually making fun of you?
そんなんじゃない。それぐらい私にだってわかる。最後に、そんなところが私らしくていいって言われたしな。
If it's enough to make Tomoyo smile and get embarrassed about, they must have been genuine words. In that case, I'd just stir things up unnecessarily if I kept asking along those lines. Alright, I understand now.
何がだ？というか、お前話をすり替えたな。私の質問に対する返答はどうした？
The bell rings. I take a look at my watch.
え？
And right after that, the bell signaling the start of fourth period rings.See you later. I fly into the classroom as if running away.
Yo.
Right when Tsunahara sits down, he starts talking to me. Why, you're early?
昨日の今日だからね。昼休みまでには出ておこうと思って。
Well, I'm thankful for that. Otherwise, I might get dragged around to wake you up again.
今日はのんびり過ごそうぜ。
Yeah, let's. Relaxing is nice.
昼は今日も学食。
I wouldn't mind eating out if you pay for me.
それ、僕が言おうと思ってたんだけど。
We're both broke. It's fine. You're high school students.
お互い貧乏だね。
Don't say that. You make us sound alike. Ouch.
混んでるね。パン買って教室に戻るか。
Okay, I believe the Bible said man does not live on bread alone. You should get something a little more than that. I know bread is delicious, but... Yeah. Get a cutlet sandwich.
バイトでも始めようかな。
At night?
うん。
You won't have the energy to go to school in the afternoon if you work at night.
肉体労働にしなければいいだけじゃん。例えば、頭を使う仕事とかね。
That's gonna be a problem for you.
そうだな。家庭教師なんていいじゃん。
What in the world are you going to teach children? I'd be terrified to send my child to you.
英語とか得意だぜ。 I am pretty dog. Ooh, are you pretty dog too?
That is terrible English.
It's miracle!
I'd say it's a miracle in the first place if you were a talking dog.
どう？発音とか完璧だろ？
I mean, A plus for trying and enthusiasm, Sunohara, but... no. You know, there's so much for me to pick apart that I don't know where to begin. That's not what they say in English. Yes, they are. Especially in high school. As if that wasn't obvious. Actually, here's something to ask. Are high school students poorer than college students? Because college students tend to generally have jobs, but they also have debt. So if you combine the debt with the jobs, college students are actually very poor. I'm still sitting myself down when I hear a voice. When I look, I see Tomoyo dragging a chair out from another table. This is still one of my favorite faces in the whole game. Sunohara and I exchange glances, and we stay like that, petrified. Bread is delicious, and Panera makes great baguettes. She pulls a chair up to my desk and sits herself down. Ooh, goodies! Like, cookies and candy? Okay, obviously, Kyo has the best facial expressions. Her demon face is equal parts awesome and kind of terrifying. I also really like Kyo's, like, smug face where she's just staring right at you with this, like, open smile, just like, heh, heh, heh. Okay, don't go fishing for compliments, Tomoyo. Come on. Just stop, okay? You're not our mom. We can eat when we want. Without asking, she opens up the bag of bread lying on the table and takes out the contents. And then thrusts the curry bread into my mouth. For Sunohara. She takes the frankfurter part of his frank roll and stuffs it into his nose. Wow! I mean, he is a jackass, but still. Sunohara is the butt monkey. Sunohara grows flushed, the frankfurter still dangling from his nose. He snaps. All the while, the frankfurter is still stuck in his nose. How about you pull that thing out first? And she's cute. Hey, bros. Don't look down on the other people. He shouts angrily at the spectators. He's got a point. Yeah, pull that feint out already. Okay, well, there's no need for different class prejudices, eh, man? That said, she has kicked you, like, 25 times at this point, so... It's very true. No, she's not. She's my girl. She's just like, well, I am dating Okazaki.
We didn't bring her, she just
walked in. That's okay, I don't mind. Maybe we mind. It seems like Tomoyo's just enjoying being treated like a normal girl. Up until now, she probably never thought she'd be the source of such frivolous talk. You're being partnered with the worst guy, though. Are you alright with Sunohara? Nah, people have already started putting you in with Suenohara, and not with me. She's just like, oh crap. Tomoyo turns towards Suenohara, looking at him as if he were some kind of vermin. I mean, she has every reason to not like him, because he tried to drag her into the men's room, because he thought she was a man. Bam! She slams both her hands down onto the desk, then stands up, looking around the classroom. Yeah, exactly. Wait, if you're not with Suenohara, then wouldn't that mean you're with me? She seats herself down again while smiling contentedly. Wow, gee, thanks.
Oi, Okazaki.
Yes? The moment Tomoyo is gone, Suenohara slams both hands on my desk. What, man? Not just me. She'll be following you around, too. Well, that's true. Although I do enjoy it when she kicks you, it would be really awful having those kinds of rumors shadowing me. No, Marty's not here. Marty's at a game day with her friends. It's fine. I still wanted to stream. Don't call me selfish, Suenohara. Suenohara puts on his evil face. Yeah, nothing says evil like that face.
Oh, dude, don't even start with this.
Yeah, she could sew your clothes back together for you when they become ragged.
So.
You are really stupid. Why are you so obsessed with this strongest stuff? Oh yeah, she did say she can make boxed lunches. We'll have her make the strongest lunch ever. I was joking. Okay, the repeating dialogue is not my favorite. It might actually be delicious, you know. I think she'd be less of a waste that way, though. A short time later, when classes have started... That's not a creepy laugh or anything. I wonder if he's fought up something, because I can hear him letting out an ominous laugh. That's actually kind of creepy. Repeating stuff comes up somewhat regularly in this game. Yeah, I know, it does. What is he doing? He's turning into a comic book villain. The classes continue. Since it's right after lunch, I'm overtaken by sleepiness. That's what happens when you eat nothing but bread for lunch. I space out. My teacher's voice almost sounds like a lullaby. Oh my gosh. When I was in middle school, I had a history teacher who had the most boring voice I've ever heard. Like, it literally would put you to sleep. I space out. My teacher's voice is like a lullaby. It feels like my eyelids are almost closed. Thud. Something hit my head. When I look down at the floor, I see a small piece of an eraser.
Okazaki!
What is it? I was just about to fall asleep. Outside. What is? What does he mean? With my eyebrows still frowned from my sleepiness, I tilt my head to peek outside the window. There at the school gate. Of course, given the time, there's no way there's anybody here. I think I just caught a glimpse of something. looks like a tiny animal moving around in small steps. It's rubbing its body against the gate wall and happily wiggling its tiny tail. Is it the... oh, Botan? It's Kyo's pet. If I remember correctly, it's a small baby boar. Is it here to see Kyo again?
Okazaki!
An irritating voice suddenly shouts out at me. I look at the teacher with my eyebrows still frowned due to my sleepiness. Wow, this is not at all how the teachers would behave at like my school. If you were sleeping, they'd just like wake you up and be like, hey, why don't you be the one to tell us and the whole class what happens when you mix these two chemicals together in chemistry class. No, in here, they're just like, look, if you want to sleep, just do it in a different classroom. Clank.
Oi, Okazaki!
Nanda? Kyoushi ni o furu tsumori ka? Sonna koto shitara, taigaku da zo!
I don't think I was doing that. Thud, thud. Bang. What is happening? Foomp. Without saying a thing, I leave the classroom amidst the silence. After a short while, I can hear the voice of the teacher coming from the classroom attempting to smooth things over. I let out a sigh, then walk down the hallway, even though it's class time. I'm in the garden next to the school gate. There is no one else here. I can faintly hear the noise of a PE class coming from the fields on the other side of the school building. Aside from that, it's completely quiet here. Amid the silence, there's a baby boar brushing its body and nose against the gate wall and wagging its tail. Botan? As I call him, his tail stands up in response. He then quickly walks toward me on his short legs like a fast-forwarding video. It seems he remembers me. Trot, trot. Hmm? Trot, trot. Hey? Trot, trot. Wham! Ow! Botan dashes and rams into me. There's a really not much of an impact since he's so small, but stop it. Hey, are you okay? They do say that boars are reckless rushers, but wow, it's true. Nah, I'm not praising you. Okay. I sit down on the grass cross-legged. Hmm? Botan looks at me, almost as if there's something he wants. He wanders around and sniffs in front of me and wiggles his tail. He peeks at me. And then he starts wandering again. He repeats the process several times, then he walks toward me as if he's made his decision. Oh? He sticks his nose between my legs and sniffs. Whack. I grab Botan by his back and hold him up to eye level. He frantically wiggles his short legs in the air. What the hell were you trying to do there? For Christ's sake, you're an animal and you're hitting on a human? Hell, actually, what even are you? Are you a guy, a girl? If you're a guy, I'm making a stew out of you. All of a sudden, I can feel that something is coming toward me. Almost instinctively, my upper body leans to the right. At that very moment, something cuts through the air with a swoosh by my left ear. Then a thud sound follows from the ground. A kanji dictionary? I turn around, thinking it can't be it. I look at the place I have in mind. Class's free ease room on the third floor. It is right next to my classroom. There I can see Kyo clearly surrounded by a menacing aura. Gah, seriously? I look at the dictionary, which has carved a crater into the ground, and let Botan go. You can throw this at that distance? If I was actually hit by that, I would have died. Hell, even if I didn't dodge it, it would have hit me. Despite my state of mind, Botan, now liberated, comes close to me again to sniff around. This time he quietly climbs up on my lap and sits there. And he seems awfully happy about it. Looks like he found a place where he feels comfortable. Even so, he found it by sniffing? I turn back to look. Far away, Kyo nods in acknowledgement. Does Kyo just, like, constantly spy on us to be like, oh, you're doing something bad, throw something at you? Seems very strange. In any case, I start patting his back. His tail wiggles happily. Since it's cute, I kept doing it for a while. Ding dong! Fifth period's over, huh? At the school building, the sound of liveliness that were absent during the class began to displace the silence. Hang on, I need to get a glass of water, so I will be right back in just a few seconds.